हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी क्रिस्टल डिफेक्ट्स और क्रिस्टल इम्परफेक्शन। एज वी नो, क्रिस्टल एंड सॉलिड्स आर कैरेक्टराइज बाय थ्री डायमेंशनल पीरियडिक अरेंजमेंट ऑफ कॉन्स्टेंट पार्टिकल्स इन स्पेस। दे शुड बी परफेक्ट इन देयर अरेंजमेंट। इट मीन्स दैट द इम्पॉर्टेंट कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ क्रिस्टल एंड सॉलिड, दैट इज रेगुलर एंड रिपीटिंग अरेंजमेंट ऑफ कॉन्स्टेंट पार्टिकल, और ऑल्सो वी कैन से ऑर्डर अरेंजमेंट ऑफ कॉन्स्टेंट पार्टिकल। हाउएवर, crystals in nature are not perfect. It means that they do not possess perfectly ordered arrangement, and therefore if some disorders or irregularities are present in the stacking of atoms or constituent particles, then such presence of irregularities or disorders in the arrangement of constituent particle of a solid crystal are called as defect or imperfections. In crystalline solid, defects are created during the process of crystallization. The imperfections are more if crystallization occur at faster rate. It means that it can be possible to minimize defects by carrying out crystallization at slower rate. The pure order arrangement is observed only at the absolute zero temperature. Above absolute zero temperature, crystalline material are not 100% pure. It means that they contain defects. Whatever be the nature of crystal defect, electrical neutrality of the crystalline solid is maintained. Electrical neutrality means presence of opposite charges like cation or anion are balanced or equal. It means that substance is electrically neutral, and it is called as electrical neutrality of solid is maintained. You have to note that sometimes for improvement of properties in crystalline solid, defects are to be intentionally created. Defects can be classified into three types. First one is point defect, second one is line defect, and third one is plane defect. In the chapter, we will learn only about point defect. Point defect can be defined as the irregularities produced in the arrangement of bases at lattice point in a crystalline solid is called as point defect. This point defect can be also defined as the irregularities from ideal arrangement around the point or an atom in a crystal is called as point defect. Point defect can be further classified into stoichiometric point defect, impurity point defect, and last one is non-stoichiometric point defect. First, we will talk about stoichiometric point defect. If imperfection or defects are present in the crystal are such that then the ratio between number of cations and number of anions remain the same as represented by molecular formula, then the defect is called as stoichiometric point defect. And also we can define this stoichiometric point defect in other way also. The ratio of number of atoms or number of cations and number of anions of compounds remain the same as represented by its chemical formula, then the defect is called as stoichiometric point defect. This defect are also called as thermodynamic defect and intrinsic defect. The stoichiometric point defects are four types. First one is vacancy defect, self-interstitial defect, Schottky defect, and last one is Frenkel defect. Now we will talk about vacancy defect. During crystallization of a solid, a particle is missing from its regular side in the crystal lattice. The missing particle creates a vacancy in the lattice structure, then the crystal is said to have a vacancy defect. This generally arises due to the absorption of heat from the surrounding, and which results in the decrease in the density of the substance. Due to the absence of particle, the mass of the substance decreases and the volume remains unchanged. Next defect is self-interstitial defect in elemental solid. Interstitial defect is caused when some of the constituent particles like atoms, ions, or molecules are present in the vacant space in the crystal structure. And these vacant spaces are known as interstitial sites. And the particles are present in these vacancies are known as interstitial. It means that some particles of a crystalline elemental solid occupy interstitial side in the crystal structure, then it is called as self-interstitial defect. This self-interstitial defect occur in two following ways. In first case, an extra particle occupy an empty interstitial space in the crystal structure. As the number of particle within the crystal increases, the density of a substance increases without increasing volume. In second case, in an elemental solid, a particle gets shifted from its original lattice point and occupy an interstitial space in the crystal. In this second case, because of displacement of a particle, a vacancy defect is created at its original regular lattice point, and at the same time interstitial defect result at its new position. In this case, density of a substance remains same. It is because neither loss nor gain in the mass of substance. It means that constant particles occupy interstitial space rather than lattice point. Both vacancy defect and interstitial defect are generally shown by non-ionic solids. Now we will talk about Schottky defect. Schottky defect is similar to vacancy defect, and this type of defect is created when equal number of cations and anions are missing from their crystal lattice. There exist two holes per ion pair lost. One created by missing cation and other created by missing anion. Such a paired cation and anion vacancy defect is known as Schottky defect. Now we will see some conditions we required for formation of Schottky defect. Schottky defect is found in highly ionic compound which have high degree of ionic character, and also they have high coordination number of anions. They also have small differences between size of cations and anions. A few examples of ionic compounds exhibiting Schottky defects are NaCl, KCl, KBr, AgBr and CHCl. Now we will see some consequences of Schottky defect. As the number of ions decreases, mass decreases while volume remains the same. When equal number of cations and anions are missing from lattice point, then electrical neutrality is maintained. Last type of stoichiometric point defect, that is Frenkel defect. If in an ionic solid a smaller ion, generally cation, goes missing from their lattice side and occupy the interstitial side, then this type of dislocation is called as Frenkel defect, and also it is called as dislocation defect. It means that Frenkel defect arises when an ion of an ionic compound is missing from its regular lattice site and occupy interstitial position between lattice point. In this case, the smaller cation is displaced from its normal site to an interstitial space, and therefore it creates a vacancy defect at its original position and interstitial defect at its new location in the same crystal. This defect definition of vacancy defect and interstitial defect. Some conditions we required for formation of Frenkel defect. Frenkel defect are common in ionic compound and which has low coordination number and the large differences in size between cations and anions. Some consequences of Frenkel defect. Since no ions are missing from the crystal lattice as a whole, Frenkel defect do not affect the density. Because of equal number of cations and anions are present, electrical neutrality is maintained. Few examples of ionic compounds exhibiting Frenkel defect are AgCl, AgBr, AgI, CaF and ZnS. Frenkel defect are found in silver halides due to the small size of silver ion, and zinc sulfide due to small size of zinc ion. This is all about crystal defect, where we learn stoichiometric point defect and four type of stoichiometric point defect which is easy to understand.